Hi, this is Mike Price from MGWA, and I'm with Jeff Williams, MGWC, CVCLD, and 2016 MGWA President. Jeff is presenting his final 2020 McEllhiney Lecture, as well as a workshop titled Realistic Budgeting to Reinvest in Your Business at Groundwater Week 2020. Welcome, Jeff. Thanks for your time.
Yeah, thank you, Mike. It's my pleasure to be here.
So let's begin. As you're presenting your final 2020 McEllhiney Lecture titled Running a Business or Doing a Job, Combining Professional Expertise with Business Savvy, what led you to choose this lecture topic?
You know, after 40 years in the industry, you see a lot of things. And we always have focused on the quality job that we did and, you know, the amount we got done in a week and satisfied customers and all that. And I think that we've strayed over the years from actually thinking about these as running businesses. Our ability to be able to reinvest in equipment, we could see that deficit, especially with a huge increase in costs in tier four emissions on these drilling rigs and the limited availability of options for us out there, really, unless you went with something really big. You know, you had to get into shallow oil and gas rigs, or now you're tied into a lot of truck engine driven stuff. But the cost itself from, let's say, 2007, 2008 to today, I mean, we've seen $200,000 to $500,000 increased in cost. That cash had to come from somewhere, right? Somewhere you had to generate that. So now we're seeing manufacturers that are making less rigs. We're seeing manufacturers buying and selling. We're seeing a rebuild market out there. We're not seeing the people being able to reinvest into new equipment. So I think that the industry needs to play a little catch up. So that's why when I look at how our business is run, I looked internally and saw that I had a knowledge deficit and that I wasn't focused on running the business aspect of it, because the squeaky wheel gets the oil, and that's the part of it that just sort of is there when you get to it. You got to make time for it. So that was the big reason that I got into the financial piece, is to raise awareness.
That makes sense. And you're also presenting a workshop titled Realistic Budgeting to Reinvest in Your Business. What are some keys to a good reinvestment strategy for one's business operation?
I take all the assets together, look at what it is as a total, and create a yearly budget to replace that asset base. So whatever the value of my assets are, with real lifetime schedules, as real as I can get, and fair values at salvage at the 7 to, you know, 10 or 15 year, however long that asset's going to be viable in my organization. And then I apply that to where I'm going to reinvest. So I think that if we're looking at the big picture, that it's a general total that I have allocated dollars to that every year. And it's just a matter of where those dollars are going to go. Based on, you know, previous revenue and forecasted revenue projections throughout the next year or 2 years. It's really hard to look forward with the state of our world and our economy is in such flux. It's really, really difficult, but we have to make our best guess and be conservative. We also, the one thing that we have to remember is we've got to add some in there for increases as well. We're not only replacing what we have right now, we have increasing costs going forward, because this stuff isn't going to get cheaper. The less manufacturers there are, the more this stuff is going to cost.
And lastly, how might one begin to better understand their current equipment valuation in relation to its business life and projected replacement timeframes and costs?
Well, I get quite a lot out of the classifieds in any one of the papers that are out there. As we look down the road, getting better with the financials, as far as understanding P&L, understanding your balance sheet, understanding your tax implications, that is where I really really started to be able to look at other numbers and make quick sense of them, right? Because there's only so many hours in a day. And if we look at what does the future hold? Are we going to see Tier 5 anytime soon? Are there going to be other market changes? And where may we be diversifying into so that we can apply revenue to that area? We want to increase revenue in another area or diversify into something else. Geothermal was a good example of diversification. Are there other areas that we can go to work in? And does that take the same piece of equipment that we're using now, or does that take something specialized? There's a whole bunch of things to look at there.
Well, great. This was really insightful, Jeff. And thanks again for your time.
No, you're very welcome, Mike, anytime. Glad to be of service to the National Groundwater Association and our membership.